And in the absence of anything else that was happening nationally or statewide, we figured, well, you know, we'll figure it out. We will try to put together a plan that will allow us to bring the students back.
So back in April, we were asked to stand up and strategically deploy highly scalable testing as part of the university's goal of reopening as safely as possible.
That we knew were going to be there. How do you try to keep everyone as safe as possible? Especially if you're going to engage them in classrooms and so on. Can we do that? And second and most important is, you know, how do we make sure that the community comes back? They are provided with enough support in terms of, you know, PPEs, in terms of carefully designed spaces to be able to do that.
Fast forward through a very intense summer of development, what we ultimately came up with was a comprehensive multimodal program in which we have data science to help us kind of predict who to test, when to test them, and how often to repeat it. We call that our target program. We have a new saliva-based test that is fast and scalable and cost-effective and free of supply chain bottlenecks. This is the iCOVID test, and we call that our testing component. And then the last piece is trying to communicate the results as fast and effectively as possible, and both the whether you're positive or negative, and then help people get safely isolated very quickly. We call that our tell component, and we pull all of that together to emphasize this is all about safety, and we call it our shield. So the whole program is called Shield, Target, Test, and Tell to reflect that multimodal kind of comprehensive nature. The way the process works is that, as you can see, we've got tents popped up all over campus, and students walk in and swipe their iCard. It generates a label, which is their specific kind of prescription for the test from Dr. Parker at McKinley. They then dribble into the tube 1 milliliter, which is about half a teaspoon of saliva. Then they just put the cap on and drop it into the rack. And then those racks of tubes are run down to the veterinary diagnostic lab using golf carts every hour. And then they're quickly run in the lab. And the results typically take between 3 to 9 hours. Obviously, so hours, not days, which is critical to the success of the program. So the nasal swab, it's uncomfortable, it's invasive, and it actually requires multiple steps. So after you do the nasal swab, then you have to use what's called viral transport medium to actually transport the virus from the swab. Then you have to do what's called an RNA isolation, which takes another step and another kit, and then finally you do the PCR reaction. And all of those things take time, they're also expensive, and they also can have supply chain bottlenecks. So if you run out of the swabs or the RNA isolation kit, etc. The key thing about this test, so my colleague Paul Hergenrother led the team that envisioned perhaps we could go directly from saliva to PCR, and it cuts out all of those supply chain and time and expensive bottlenecks. And so there's no swab, there's no viral transfer media, and there's no RNA isolation. It's simply saliva in a tube. We then heat it at 95 degrees for 30 minutes, which inactivates the virus, and we think also opens it up so you can expose the RNA and allow us to directly detect it. And it goes straight through the buffer into the PCR reaction. And so it's very simple, but also very fast and scalable. And because that first step is just heating the tube before it gets open, it helps make it much safer for the workers in the lab, and that's allowed us to do things on a very large scale and do so safely. So all of those features come together to make this test very practical and effective on a very large scale.
I believe Indiana University is going to be setting up something like what we have for the spring semester. Wisconsin-Madison is thinking about it. Notre Dame is having a very similar test to what we are having for their university. And the list goes on.
So for COVID-19 on the semesters, and the students that go around campus passing out masks, hand sanitizers, and sunglasses to students and staff. And we also do giveaways and hand out mugs or hats or sweatshirts to students who are doing a great job socially distancing and wearing their masks. Chancellor writes things, or has like a pre-written thank you note that everyone gets if they win a giveaway. It just says thanks for doing your part to keep us on campus and socially distancing and keeping us safe.
So no matter how frequently we test you, we want you to wear your mask. We want you to be mindful of the fact that that you know you're really wearing your mask not only for yourself but for the others around you.
Let's keep finding that partnership between you know the Shield team and the students so that ultimately we can together be incredibly proud of the story that we're writing together. We're showing the world that it is possible to stay open safely, get back to all the things we care about in society,
and everybody do their part. I think that's absolutely key, right? Wearing your mask, staying socially distanced, and making really smart choices about how we socialize.